China used to be the world's biggest importer of waste, but now the country has banned plastic and solid waste imports. And as a result, Western countries have started to rely on developing countries to take in their exported waste, including some in Southeast Asia. Yet, the adverse environmental impact has led those countries to either ban or consider banning trash imports as well.
Malaysia, the Philippines, and Vietnam are among Southeast Asian countries accusing rich nations of using them as a dumping ground.
Although China has stopped importing waste from other nations, it still has to contend with what it generates within its own borders. E-commerce and food delivery are two industries that have seen immense growth in the 21st century, while they have also accounted for a substantial increase in domestic waste. In 2005, China accounted for less than 1% of the global e-commerce market, but currently, over 44% of the world's e-commerce deals happen in China. China has been the world's biggest e-commerce and online retail market for 8 consecutive years since 2013. In 2020, e-commerce sales in China increased by 28.8% from the previous year to reach $2.3 trillion, while the market is projected to reach $3.57 trillion by 2024, according to Statista. Three Chinese e-commerce powerhouses alone, including Alibaba-owned Taobao and Tmall, JD.com, and newly emerged Pinduoduo, accounted for almost half of the global sales in 2019. Yet, the ever-increasing online market has given rise to a huge waste problem. The e-commerce industry generates 10 million tons of packaging waste every year in China, with around 23% of it being unrecyclable. Such waste is typically buried in a landfill or incinerated. Chinese e-commerce platforms and logistics firms mainly use four types of parcel packaging: plastic bags, carton parcels, woven bags, and biaxially oriented polypropylene, also known as BOP bags. Statistics from the State Post Bureau showed that 80% of paper or carton packaging material can be recycled, while almost all plastic material cannot be fully reused. At the current pace, the country's e-commerce sector is projected to generate 41.3 million tons of plastic waste a year by 2025, which is more than the entire plastic waste generated in the U.S. in 2018. To alleviate the environmental impact, the government has introduced new legislation and carried out plans to reduce the waste and recycle more efficiently. In April of 2021, China's State Post Bureau launched a nationwide campaign to crack down on the overpackaging problem. The National Development and Reform Commission also issued a new policy to ban the production, sale, and use of non-biodegradable and one-off plastic products, which will be gradually implemented over the next 5 years, with a focus on the fast-growing e-commerce, delivery, and takeout industries. Alibaba-owned logistics company Cainiao has reduced the size of its package labels from 2014, an initiative that has saved 430 billion sheets of paper from 2014 to 2020. Cainiao have also begun trialing partially degradable bags and has installed over 80,000 recycling bins around the country, where customers can return their parcels packaging. JD.com has implemented slimmer degradable tape and has introduced reusable packaging boxes, according to the company. Still, all these government and private measures may not be enough to effectively reduce the waste problem when measured against the rapid growth of the e-commerce sector. How to step up efforts to deal with growing e-commerce waste poses a challenge for lawmakers, but an even trickier one arises from the country's takeout industry, where mountains of greasy trash are churned out every day. China is currently the world's biggest online food delivery market. Its value reached $51.5 billion in 2020, after years of fast growth. The landscape is dominated by two giants, Meituan and Ele.me, leaving less than 1% of the remaining market share for other competitors. Every year, tens of millions of food deliveries are made across China, leading to huge amounts of packaging trash, including items like chopsticks, plastic spoons, plastic bowls, bamboo skewers, aluminum foil, and plastic bags, much of which is tossed as unrecyclable garbage due to being contaminated by food or being uneconomical to recycle. Using more biodegradable materials can be one way to tackle the waste problem in the takeout sector. An ambitious 5-year plan made by the State Post Bureau has targeted takeout waste. By 2025, China is set to ban the production and use of non-biodegradable and one-off plastic straws, bags, and other plastic utensils. Some restaurants in China have already taken actions. Yum China Holdings, operator of KFC and Pizza Hut in the country, vows to cut its use of environmentally harmful plastics by almost a third in the next 5 years by shifting to paper straws and biodegradable packaging. McDonald's announced a test in Beijing to stop providing straws unless upon request, and have created lid designs for drinking without straws. Similar measures have also been adopted by other big names, including Starbucks, which ended the use of plastic straws completely in 2020. Food delivery platform Meituan Ele.me have also started requiring users to select whether they need utensils or not before paying for meals. These platforms are also offering guidance to merchants about portion sizes and other information about the dishes to better help customers make ordering decisions that minimize food waste. In 2017, China started to draft its long-awaited household garbage sorting legislation, intending to implement the garbage classification policy in all major cities and pledging that 35% of urban household waste would be recycled by 2020. Yet, actions speak louder than words. And even if there's no official data available yet, it seems like the progress has been slow. The policy comes with an interesting phenomenon. In cities where a vast bulk of garbage is generated, community members would collect community waste, such as paper, boxes, and bottles, which are then sold to local recycling centers. Although several cities have implemented stricter waste disposal measures within communities, the actual accountability varies. In Shanghai, there are reportedly fines for improper sorting of waste. While in Beijing, some communities are stricter than others. According to a 2019 survey by the Chinese Ministry of Ecology and Environment, only 30% of interviewees reported they were doing well or relatively well when it came to garbage sorting. In many communities, despite the presence of different bins for waste sorting, some residents haven't changed their habits, choosing to throw all of their waste into the same bin. Then it's up to scavengers and community members to sift through the trash and pick out recyclable items, with the rest of the trash presumably ending up incinerated or in a landfill. With landfills running out of room and waste-generating industries growing rapidly, can the government, private sector, and individuals work collectively to save the environment and time?